लीवर, मसल लीवर, स्टार्लिंग हार्ट लीवर, वाइब्रेटिंग रीड, कीज, मर्क्यूरी की एंड शॉर्ट सर्किटिंग की, पॉल्स कम्यूटेटर, ड्यूबॉइस डायमंड इंडक्शन कॉइल एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक टाइम मार्कर। नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट राइटिंग लीवर। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट मसल लीवर। इट इज एल शेप्ड लीवर विच इज यूज फॉर मैग्नीफाइंग एंड रिकॉर्डिंग मसल कॉन्ट्रैक्शन। इट हैज वन हॉरिजॉन्टल आर्म विच बेयर्स अ राइटिंग पॉइंट। दिस इज मेड अप ऑफ अ ट्राइंगुलर पीस ऑफ फोटोग्राफिक फिल्म। एट इट्स एंड एंड ऑन द अदर एंड देर आर फ्यू होल्स ऑन विच वेट कैन बी हंग नियर द फल्क्रम। ऑन द वर्टिकल आर्म देर इज अ हुक, दिस वन, टू विच द टेंडन ऑफ द मसल इज टाइड वाया थ्रेड। इट हैज वन आफ्टरलोड स्क्रू। दिस आफ्टरलोड स्क्रू प्रेजेंट नियर द फल्क्रम ऑफ द लीवर विच कैन लिमिट द डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ द फल्क्रम टू डिजायर लेवल। Afterload screw fitting in the frame supports the vertical arm, or it can be withdrawn away from it like this in freeloading condition. Muscle lever can be mounted on the wall of Lucas Moyes chamber. This is Starling's heart lever. It is used for recording the mechanical events of the frog's heart. It is sensitive writing lever because of presence of the spring. This lever is used to record the isotonic contractions of the heart, which are relatively weaker than skeletal muscle contractions. Here, a piece of thread is tied to the lever, which carries a bent pin, which can be hooked through the apex of the ventricle. When the ventricle contracts, the contractions are recorded by the movement of this lever. You can see here, this way. When heart contracts, it pulls the lever down, and when it relaxes, the spring pulls the lever back to its original position. This lever is mounted on the myograph stand. Now, next is vibrating reed. It is a metal strip mounted on a stand. The metal contact point dips into the mercury cup from which a wire is taken to complete the circuit. This is mercury cup. It is a device to give desired number of induction shocks, depending on the free length of the reed. We can give 5 to 30 stimuli per second. This way we can change the number of stimuli per second. Next is key. Any device which is used for interrupting or completing a circuit is known as key or a switch. Two types of keys are used in experimental work: a simple key, this is, as well as short circuiting key. This is also known as mercury key or primary key. This is simple key for making or breaking circuits, whereas short circuiting key can be used for making or breaking the circuit as well as for diverting the current through a path of very low resistance to cause a short circuit. Here, this key has two terminals which are embedded in mercury cups. These are mercury cups for low resistance contact. Now, next is pulse commutator. It is modified mercury key acting as two-way switch. It is used to change the direction of current. It consists of a vulcanite base on which A rocking metallic cradle is mounted. There are six cup-like depressions filled with mercury, and six terminals are attached to these cups. These are six terminals. The electric current is diverted to two different points of a tissue through the electrodes connected at either ends. Next is Dubois-Raymond induction coil. Principle: it is a device by which low voltage, high ampere, direct continuous current, which is DC, that is converted into induced current. Induced current is high voltage, low ampere, phasic current, also known as alternate current. It consists of a primary coil fixed on a frame and a movable secondary coil covering the primary coil but having no connection with primary coil. As the current is passed in primary coil, there occurs a change in the magnetic field in the surrounding space. This change produces a momentary current in the secondary coil. Thus, starting, stopping, or alternating the strength of the current in the primary circuit induces a current of momentary duration in the secondary coil. Primary coil consists of turns of relatively thick cotton-covered copper wire wound around a wooden reel. Secondary coil has much large number of turns than primary coil. In the secondary coil, the copper wire, they are of thin enameled and wound around hollow wooden reel. Base, it is in the form of a wooden plate which gives stability. It is grooved and the secondary coil slides over it. You can see here. It carries a scale to measure the distance of secondary coil from the primary coil. If the base is wooden, it has a hinge on which it can be folded to half. You can see here. This is the hinge joint. Now, when the primary circuit is closed, as we all know that we can close the circuit by dipping the terminal of primary key in the mercury cup, the magnetic field within the secondary coil increases slowly, that is from zero to maximum, and an induced electromotive force develops in the secondary circuit. Conversely, when the primary circuit is broken, we can break the circuit by this way. The magnetic flux within the secondary coil drops very rapidly to zero and a strong induced current develops. Thus, the induced current is strongest at break than at make. The closer the secondary coil is to the primary coil, the stronger is the magnetic field of the primary coil, and therefore the stronger the current induced in the secondary coil. The induced current is strongest when the two coils are parallel and weaker when they are at angle, and the current is least or zero when they are at right angles. Now, Knibbs hammer, it is a built-in automatic interrupter connected in series with the primary coil of the induction coil. This is Knibbs hammer. It works on the principle of an electric bell. It interrupts the primary circuit about 40 times per second to maximum and produces repeated induced current of the same frequency in the secondary circuit. Next is electromagnetic time marker. It is used to mark time in cardiac experiment. It is used along with the central low voltage unit and can provide make break contacts at interval. Thank you.